Here we have an organization that's dedicated directly toward helping Muslims who are confronting a government who often is abusive. And unless you stand up to that abuse, you get trampled by it. And that's why I think the Muslim Legal Fund and the Constitutional Center are so important, because they play that role of being, in a way, the last defender of people's rights in the Muslim community. CARRP basically says, we don't know that this person has done anything bad. We don't have any evidence that they've done anything bad. In other words, evidence and facts under the 1% Cheney doctrine are thrown out the window. Sounds very familiar to what's happening today. We really don't care about the evidence or facts. If we have some suspicion that something is wrong, we will take action. If someone is seeking an immigration benefit and we have some vague suspicion, no evidence, no facts, but we think that he may be involved in something that's either illegal, because it doesn't only have to be terrorism, or involved in terrorism, we're just not going to adjudicate the application. We're not going to make a decision on it. And if we're forced to make a decision on it, we're going to make up anything we can to deny it. That's basically what the CARRP program is. It's really remarkable. You know, we've come up with this expression. When people tell us these cases, we say, you've been CARRP'd. meaning you've waited 2 years, 3 years, 5 years. And sometimes people think, well, we're waiting because they're just incompetent or because the petition's lost. No. That isn't why they're waiting. They're waiting because they're instructed not to make decisions in these cases. And so the offices really don't have any incentive to clear these cases. So they just let them sit there until you sue them.